Do you want to sit there or no? So Jordan, I'll ask you a question, and if you agree, please respond I will. As long as you both shout it.
I will.
And then I'll ask you a similar question, and if you agree, please respond I will. Effie, will you take Jordan to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shout it? And to all family and friends gathered here today, I ask you a similar question, and if you agree, please respond, we will. So will you, the family and friends of Becky and Jordan, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come? There's a lot of you here, you can say it a bit louder, like you mean it. Don't be shy. We'll say it again, you say it like me, right? Will you, the family and friends of Becky and Jordan, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
Yeah.
Fantastic. So we'll say a prayer now for the marriage service. Let us pray. So we ask that, so we now come to the marriage. And I ask, who brings this woman to be married to this man?
Becky and Jordan, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. So Jordan, if you go first, and repeating after me, but looking at each other. I, Jordan.
Take you, Becky.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow. Okay, so you lose hand. So, Becky, if you'll take Jordan's hand in your right hand to make your vow to him now. I, Becky.
Take you, Jordan.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow. So as a symbol of those special vows that Becky and Jordan make today, they're going to each now give and receive a ring. And I'll take that from James. Brilliant, thank you. That's you, you can sit that
down. I want that back after, Bob.
Is it a cigarette case?
Yeah. Had it for a few years.
Jordan, if you'll take Becky's ring and place that on her ring finger. Brilliant. And holding it there and repeating after me. Becky, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Okay. So if you lose hands, and Becky, you take Jordan's ring and again place that on his finger. Jordan, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Okay.
So just remain holding hands then. So in the presence of God and before this congregation, Becky and Jordan have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. So Jordan, you may kiss your wife.
You did well, Beth.
Would you all please stand for that happy couple?
Thank you. You sing beautifully, actually.
That's the wrong speech. Is that better? Yeah. Can we hear now? Are we? Right. Right. Hi, everyone. For those of you who don't already know me, I'm Steve. I'm Becky's proud dad and Jordan's brand new father-in-law. And hope you enjoy the next few minutes of this evening that Becky couldn't plan and has no control over. On behalf of Bev and myself, I'd like to begin by welcoming you all and thank you for coming to this very special occasion to celebrate the marriage of our daughter Becky to Jordan. It's wonderful to see you all with us and hope you have a fabulous time tonight. Having done this a couple of times already, I believe this is the part of the speech I'm supposed to say something about Becky herself. Well, she's always been very determined and very competitive. She's never liked losing. And although she's the baby of the family, she's always enjoyed standing head and shoulders above the rest of us. Is that right? As well as being very determined, she's also very hardworking, and we're both very proud of her and her well-deserved achievements. As the Birch family has a long-standing history with Bewdley, it's lovely to see both Becky and Jordan happily established as part of the community there, be it on the river, railway, or more likely in the brewery. What more can I say about our awesome, cruelly amazing daughter, other than how beautiful and radiant she's looking today and how proud we are to have as a daughter, and I'm sure Jordan will be proud to call his wife. Talking of Jordan, I think it's about time to formally welcome you into the family. Although we've known you for so long, we already think of you at that anyway. It was because of your involvement in the Severn Valley Railway that you and Becky first met at that 1940s event, and I'm sure all your experience on the railways will help keep you both on the right track in the future. During the time we've known Jordan, we've come to know how considerate and genuine he is and how much he clearly means to Becky. Vanessa and Dave, Jordan is an absolute credit to you both. They both seem so happy together and are a perfect match for each other and make a great team. Having been together a while now already, you both clearly worked out how to make a relationship work. So don't think there's much more advice that I can give other to say to Jordan. A word of advice from my experience, if you remember that this marriage is just a union in which one person, in your case my daughter, is always right, and the other is you, you'll be fine. Before I take a seat, I have one last task to perform, and it's a task that is both my honour and my privilege. Ladies and gentlemen, please raise your glasses and join with me in wishing the newlyweds a long, healthy, and very happy future together. To Becky and to Jordan.
Becky and Jordan.
Thank you.
Thank you to Steve and Bev and Dave and Nessa for all your help and support along the way. We couldn't have done it without you. And to be fair, literally, we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you guys anyway. So, you know, there you go. Also, I'd like to thank, there's a few people actually that's made today very special, you know, with the trucks and all that sort of stuff. So I'd like to thank Ed and Shoal, who's helped a lot with the hair and makeup and all that sort of logistical nightmare that I was rubbish at dealing with. It was a bit stressful. Lawrence and Tom, there, for providing the buses. Thank you very much for that. And I know it's a lot of hard work goes into maintaining them and keeping them on the road. Scott, for providing the wedding car. Thank you very much again. Tim, who is not here tonight, but he sorted the beer. So I've got to, well, really my thanks to you, Ian, actually, for sorting the beer this morning. So thank you very much. And Pete, down the back there, for playing the organ for us, which was absolutely amazing. Don't inflate his ego too much. It was amazing. I believe he had a nice warm-up gig a few weeks ago as well. So cheers for that. Thank you to everybody else for attending today and your generous gifts. And if they're not generous, well, we know where you live. So thank you, Jim, for being my best man, sorting out all this morning, which wasn't a nightmare, was it? But it was a bit of a test. Is the bacon done yet? Thank you to him for being my best man and my best friend. Jim has been there for me and Becky for so many years. And nothing is ever too much of a problem, really, for you. You've literally become our third wheel. I don't know how you want to take that, but you know. Well, just the normal. Thanks to the ushers. Well, they all spread about for all your help today. People would have literally not known where to sit if it weren't for you. So, you know, top job. The biggest thank you must go to the most important person here today, which is obviously Becky. you've organised this whole gig pretty much single-handedly. As she keeps reminding me near enough every single day. And it's been one hell of a day so far. It's been absolutely amazing. And you look stunning. And I can't wait to start our new chapter together. The last bit, so you don't get too bored. And somebody mentioned I have to compliment the bridesmaids. So you're all looking beautiful, 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 beautiful. Where you're all spread about. No, honestly, you all look amazing. And thank you for your support and all that you've done up to and including today and for everything you've done for Becky. So on that note, can I ask everyone to join me in a toast to the bridesmaids? Right, and that's me done anyway, so you can clap at this point now.
Good afternoon, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jim. Thank you. And it's an absolute privilege and pleasure to have been chosen by Jordan to be here on this special occasion as his best man. Firstly, I must say what an amazing day today has been. Becky, you look incredible. The bridesmaids, you all look beautiful, as does all the bridal party. And it's nice to see that most of you have made an effort, which is good. It isn't every day you get the opportunity to talk publicly about a man who's blessed with good looks, charm, intelligence and personality, but we're not here to talk about me, it's about Jordan. I've known Jordan for about 20 years now, and he's always been the straight-talking, loyal, dedicated and motivated person we all know and love. He's the most easygoing, calm, chilled person I know. He's known by many names to his friends and his enemies. Blondie, Teeth, Goofy, Jord, Geordie, the Kid. He's a man of many passions, mainly volunteering on the Seven Valley Railway, repairing his own vintage vehicle and all of ours. And he's big into walking. He walks to the brewery, he walks to the Western, and he walks to the Black Boy on the Hill. So it's a big, big passion. No, he's a great guy, the best friend that anyone could ask for. And I know that he's going to be an amazing husband to Becky. But however, he has a few peculiar habits. which definitely now is the time to share with you all. He's the only person I know who sweeps the roof of his house.
You've got to get the moss off. Is it moss?
At 31, he still views a pinky promise as legally binding. Whenever he sees a Royal Mail vehicle, he has to tell you that he used to work on them. And finally, the world will literally end if he walks over 3 drain covers. So, I've only ever seen Jordan genuinely scared twice since I've known him. The first time was when he left his beloved tobacco tin on a train and had to wait 24 hours to be reunited with it. He rescued this tin originally from a skip and he's never without it. So you can only imagine the worry as we waited for the police and search and rescue to locate the missing tin. The second time he was nervous was when he told me that he was planning to propose to Becky on Christmas Eve 2021. Happily, I can report that both stories have a happy ending. The tin was found, Becky said yes, and we're all here today to celebrate. Over the years that Jordan and Becky have been together, the phrase Jordan and Becky has become a certainty to everyone who knows them. Like salt and pepper, day and night, knife and fork. You can't imagine one without the other. They complement each other's lives and the happiness that they share spreads into the lives of everyone who knows them. Jordan, you couldn't have found a more beautiful, wonderful person to spend the rest of your life with. And Becky, well, you can't win them all, can you? But no, seriously, I wish you both a long, happy and healthy life together. So that only leaves me with one last thing to say. Will you all please raise your glasses and join me in a toast to Mr. and Mrs. Taylor, to Jordan and Becky.
Guys.
Cheers.
You see, we didn't get out of it that easy.
How much you've enjoyed today?
Oh, yes, superb. Superb.
Yes.
Beautiful. Oh,
yes.
Lovely day.
Lovely atmosphere. Really happy for them both.
Nice to get together.
Yeah.
And the sunshine. What else?
Cut.
That's not even like full down. Oh my god, I'm like, please pretend it's something I can handle.
So now we're off.
This video.
This is what I put.
Very good.
These are hurting my neck.
Go on. Imagine you're at the cinema and you're going to start getting more and more cuddly. Go on. It's a romantic film.
How much you paid this, mate?
Perfectly fine. Yeah, just a bit of oil, be fine. The rest was sand.
mostly music for the right group on this Saturday evening. Joe Bowden, how long? Please put your hands together for the bride and groom.